So did your character ever expect he'd have competition for Emma?
I don't think he ever did, so that's why it's like so jolting. He like sees this new guy come in and he's like, what is going on? And then when it comes out that he messed up and like stuff with Nina, it's like, oh, it's on. Like, you gotta repair that ASAP. So yeah, it's a little surprising for him.
What do you think is appealing?
Man, we have so many theories, I can't even tell you. The writers don't tell us anything. Like, we're on the ride with you guys. So, if you have any input, I am open to your suggestions, because we have no idea.
Would you mind if
I do? I would love it to. Oh my gosh, that'd be the coolest thing ever. Yeah, we'll see.
If it were you, would you like to know ahead of time?
I would. That way I can, like, prep for it in the scenes leading up to it, you know? We'll see. Hopefully they tell me something. If.
So as you continue to explore the character, is there anything on a personal level you found that you're surprised to learn about yourself?
Like that I found through being with the character?
Yeah.
Actually, I can get kind of into it. Will has a lot of anger with him. He's very frustrated. He's very passionate. I've actually found some of that inside of me. Like, you find that you're like, oh, I am, I'm really passionate about that. Like, that's really interesting. So definitely, as you sink into the character and you find yourself coming out, it just changes it. You learn a lot about
yourself. Scary a little bit?
Oh yeah, it's scary. I mean, I get it why actors get freaked out, get lost in their parts. You know, you just get too involved and you get really deep in there. And there's sometimes where I'd walk away just being like, all right, I'm really in a funk now. Like, that was really upsetting. Okay, you know, it's freaky. It's really cool.
So you consider yourself a method actor?
2 points. That's a good question.
To kill somebody.
Yeah, right, of course not. Yeah, just I'll be right back. No, I like to push it to keep it real. I don't like disappear for 2 days and like disappear into a character. But if I'm supposed to be like jumping off something, I prefer to jump off it. I like to make it as real as possible. If I'm supposed to get like be physical with somebody, like I'll make sure it's safe, but I'm like, be physical with me. Like, don't take the safety away, because that's the only way it's going to feel authentic. So up to a point, you know what I mean? I like to keep a good balance, so it doesn't get crazy. Gotta be safe.
Is there anything you guys do to break up the intensity?
You just, as an actor, you learn in class how to put the brakes on, you know? So if it gets too intense, you walk away and you break, you know? There's breaks and tricks in the world, for sure.
Have the fans online started deciding who they'd rather see Emma with?
Oh, yeah.
They started shipping you in the day?
Oh, yeah. There's Team Kieran and there's Team Will. And they've also even gone as far as giving us names. It's like Emirin and Emil or something like that. Like, they've like combined the names and the Hollywood names. And then, I'm going to be honest, most of the online fans are on Team Kieran. And it's like, yeah, it's okay. I understand. We'll see how that plays out. So, no, it's hilarious, though.
Well, is Will going to have a chance to redeem himself?
He's going to have to. If he wants to be back with Emma, which he clearly wants to do, he's going to have to change something, because the way he's going is not working. You know, it's not working.
Do you think he's a good guy?
At heart, absolutely. He's focused. He just wants to do the right thing. He's driven. You know, it's just, he gets into stuff. He gets passionate. That's his thing. But ultimately, he's a good guy. He wants to do the right thing. Yeah.
Is basketball going to be for Scream what lacrosse was for Teen Wolf?
In a way, yes. You know, the story's mostly about the drama and everything, but, I mean, basketball's what drives Will. You know, like, he is the captain, and he wants to go to Duke. He wants to get the scholarship and get out of town and start his life. So basketball is definitely a huge part of the story for Will.
So what are some of the themes of the upcoming episode?
The themes are, we're going to start getting into the actual story. I use an analogy, like, we've been on the upward roller coaster, and we've established the characters, we have all the problems, and now it's going to go through the rack. Like, we have all the stories are going to start unfolding, and people are going to start going through their changes. It's going to get crazy from here on.
Is there any sense of humor on the show?
Oh, absolutely. And a lot of it is twisted. Like, a lot of times you laugh, and you're like, oh, I shouldn't have laughed with that. That was really twisted. But, like, definitely Noah delivers a lot of the humor, a lot of, like, the rule setting. And so there's definitely a way to laugh at it. It's very tongue-in-cheek, though. It's very self-aware.
Very dry?
Very dry. Yeah. Yes, it has to be. When you're dealing with death. Yeah.
Since we're going to get to see Bella again in flashbacks, will Will be in any of those scenes?
Well, we have, yet to be seen for a lot of it. But yes, absolutely, it will be in that way for sure.
Maybe things won't be quite what they seem in that front.
Exactly. And now that's exactly it. We're going to kind of ping-pong you guys around and let you kind of take the ride with us. Yeah.
Do you know of any particular, like, death scenes, upcoming death scenes that are pretty epic?
You know, I say yes. I can't say anything else, but you know, there's some really cool stuff coming. Because we're all on borrowed time. You know, everybody who touches the show is on borrowed time. Nobody's safe. So get ready.
What are your favorite horror movies?
I love more of the thriller side of horror movies, so like Sixth Sense, The Others, Signs, like those kind of movies. The gore and the stuff like freaks me out, but if it's really suspenseful and thrilling, totally bad.
How do you feel about the fan reactions to the series? Everything's been incredibly positive. I mean, here at the Comic-Con, it's been amazing.
It's been amazing. We're really nervous because it's people could have taken it the new direction very negatively, and they've been nothing but positive and loving to us, and we feel very lucky that they're taking it so well, and they fall in love with the cast, and they really see our friendship come alive, and it's been really amazing.
Have you seen the original Scream
movies? Yes. They're amazing. And actually, Scream 1 was the whole reason why I was able to tolerate horror in the first place. Because I watched it, and I was freaked out, and then I saw...
How old were you?
I was like... But when it came out, I was 3. So I definitely saw it a few times. Whoa, sorry. 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 No, you're welcome. Sorry, everyone. I'll take my leave. It was great talking to you. No, but when I saw it, it was pretty recently, actually. Pretty recent when I saw it, but I watched it and then auditioned for this, and I just was like a fan from after I watched the first one, and it's just been a ride ever since. So I get the series so well because I watched it. And as a cast, we like watched all of them together to like form it and build it, and it's been pretty cool.